We've gotten consistent reports that they can't get through to operators at the New York State Department of Labor. This has been going on for weeks. What sort of assurances can you offer residents that they can get these benefits, particularly in times of economic hardship?
Yeah. Look, the technology at the Department of Labor, the system just crashed because of the volume, right? It's one of those unanticipated consequences of a situation like this. And again, Jesse, nobody's been here before. We'll learn for the next time. But yeah, you have a government shuts down the private sector economy. You have millions of out of work. The next shoe to drop is going to be millions of people call in for unemployment benefits, crashing the system that handles the unemployment benefits because you've had a hundredfold increase, which is what has happened. We have 1,000 people who are now working on just personnel for that incoming system. Think about that, 1,000 people who are working on processing applications for unemployment benefits. That was like the number we used to get of applicants. Now we have 1,000 people processing applications. We're working with Google to come up with an online mechanism that bypasses any phone certification. The phone certification was important because you want to make sure that people who are applying are also qualified. So we're doing everything we can. The good news is, whenever you sign up, your benefits are going to be retroactive. You will not have received the check. I get that, and that's causing anxiety. But it's not like you're not going to get the same benefit because you didn't get through on Monday and you didn't get through until Thursday. Melissa's been working on the system. You want to give an update?
Sure. So just to give everybody a little bit of context, these numbers will come out later today, but last week there were 350,000 unemployment claims in New York. Going back to March 9th, we're at 810,000 unemployment claims. So far, 600,000 of those claims have been successfully processed, so you've got over 200,000 that are still in partial status. What happens is you go online, you fill out the application. If you fill out the application in full, you're done. If you leave any of the fields blank, what's been happening is they tell you call the system. So you call the system to follow up. That's what then caused the crash in volume, and then the system goes down. As the governor said, we've been working with Google. Today, between 5 and 7 p.m., the system is going to go down to reboot. 7 o'clock, the new application goes online. It's streamlined. There are fewer questions. And once you get to the end of that, if you successfully fill it out, it's going to say you're finished with the application process. If there's any information that's left blank, it's going to say don't call us. We will call you within 72 hours. And DOL, as the governor said, now has 1,000 people on the phone lines. They're going to be reaching out directly to the people so that people don't have to go through this infuriating process of calling and getting busy signals and thereby collapsing the system. So hopefully starting today after 7 o'clock, the system will be much better streamlined. But as the governor said, it's a volume issue that we've never experienced.